Hello, my name is Diane, and I work at the Pikesville branch of Baltimore County Public Library. Thank you for joining me today for my steam-powered program. Today, we will be doing an elevator building challenge by creating a lifting machine similar to this. However, I'm not going to tell you exactly how to build it. I'm going to give you some guidelines and suggestions, show you some examples, and then let you create your own. So what will we need for this challenge? We will need something to support our structure. You can use two paper towel tubes, just like these. You could also use a cardboard box. If you want a really tall elevator, use a bigger box. We will need something to go across to serve as a crank for our elevator. You could use a stick like this one I found outside. You could use a wooden dowel, but most people don't have those at home. I found some sticks around the house and just taped them together to give them a little bit more strength. You could also use a wire hanger, just clip off the bottom piece. We'll need some stringing material to create the lift of our elevator. You could use some heavy thread. You can use some twine or even just normal string. You're also going to need some sort of container because an elevator doesn't have a purpose unless it has something that you can actually lift up. You could use some paper cups. You could use the bottom piece of an egg carton. You could also use just a piece of cardboard, fancy it up to create a platform for your elevator. We will also use some of our basics. We will need tape or glue and some scissors. I'd also suggest a pen. Why use a pen for this project? Well, if you have a piece of cardboard and you need to put a hole in it and you really don't want to risk stabbing yourself or cutting yourself, a pen works really well. You just take the pen and your piece of cardboard, put the pen up, twist it back and forth, and it will put a hole in your cardboard and no risk of being cut. Just a little tip to add. Okay, so let's show you some examples. This is our first one. This I used two paper towel tubes, taped a lot to this cardboard base. I used a stick I found outside, some thread that I had around the house, and I cut out a piece of an egg carton. We want to put something in there to carry. I'm simply using some pennies, and this is only about 7 or 8 pennies. So you put it into the little container, and then you hit the crank, and it raises and works beautifully as an elevator. Now you could trade it your own and you can see how many pennies that you could be able to lift. Maybe if your structure is really sturdy, maybe you could lift 50 pennies, maybe 100 pennies. It's up to you how strong you make it. You could also try using this one. In this case, I used the same paper towel holders. I used a piece of wire, some paper cups, and in this case, they're just shoelaces. These are just some purple shoelaces I happen to have around the house. In this case, though, notice on this particular, on the one on this side, I taped it to a wire. In this one, I used part of a cardboard tube and then put the shoelace around the cardboard tube. Why did I do this? Well, if you raise these up, which you get by turning, you will find that the one going around the larger one goes faster. So this is something else you can experiment with when you're doing your project. And last, we're going to show you a cardboard box example. So for this one, I used some of those taped up rods that I had earlier. I used a cardboard box that I cut out the one side of, a little piece of cardboard for a platform, and then some string to hold it together. Again, if you twist it, it will raise. In this case, you notice my platform isn't staying very flat, and so whatever I put on it would probably fall off. This is something, again, that you have to take into account when you're working on your project. So now it's up to you. Can you take some of these materials or other materials around your house and build a great elevator that holds lots and lots of stuff? I'd love to see what you come up with. Feel free to comment on this video with your descriptions of what you did or photos of what you did and how many pennies that you lifted. So thanks again for joining me today. If you want ideas on projects like these, please see our website, bcpl.info. Thanks again for joining me. Goodbye.